Aristotle once said, "We are what we repeatedly do." Therefore, excellence is not an act, it is a habit. A very good morning to one and all present here. My wishes to have a very beautiful Thursday. This morning, I have a very remarkable verse to share with you all, and I've taken it from the book of Proverbs, chapter 16 and verse 3. It says, "Commit to the Lord whatever you do, and your plans will succeed." Dear friends, as you all know that we are meditating on the theme defining excellence throughout this month, I would like to insist a point that committing one's deeds and plans to the Lord is an important stride on a road leading towards excellence. So let's all now look unto our Lord, appealing for the wisdom and grace to commit our ways to Him completely and faithfully, so that we may savor success. Let's pray. Our most gracious and glorious Heavenly Father, we thank you for this morning session, Lord Master. Lord, even now, we pray that you help us to commit our ways into your hands and succeed, so that we may become ourselves a definition for excellence. Lord, I also commit this entire assembly session into your mighty hands. Lead us throughout and take complete control. We also remember and place all the activities of today and the entire endeavors that are about to take place in our campus at your mighty presence. Lord, you take complete control, lead us and guard us. In the most mighty and matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we ask and pray. Amen. Now let's all tie up with the choir and sing praises to our Lord.
Oh, I have heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. I've seen many searching for answers far and wide, but I know we're all searching for answers. Only you provide, 'cause you know just what we need before we say a word. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways to us. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. To us. Oh, it's love so undeniable. I can hardly speak. A peace so unexplainable. I can hardly think as you call. Deeper still as you call me. deeper still as you call me, deeper still into love, love. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are, it's who you are, it's who you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am, it's who I am, it's who I am. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are, it's who you are, it's who you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am, it's who I am, it's who I am.
Very good morning to all of you. For today's thought, the word of God is taken from the book of Genesis chapter 41 verse 51. Joseph called the name of the firstborn Manasseh, for God has made me forget all my toil and all my father's house. A year before, I was called to speak to a few group of girls in one of the arts and science of colleges in Coimbatore. I was asked to address, speak to the students on personality enhancement. At the end of the session, the organizer came to me and she requested me to speak to one particular girl. She told me like this, she's very good in her studies. Recently, she lost her 9-year-old brother by an accident, sudden death, and because of which the whole total house was in, you know, great agony, and this girl was not able to study and she wanted to discontinue. And I asked her, did you speak to her parents? And they said, yeah, we went to her house and spoke to the parents also. Parents said, if at least my daughter is at home, that we can forget the misery of losing our son. Like that, they were also convinced to take her back from the college. Then I met that girl and I asked her what she wanted to do. She said that I'm not able to sit in the class. I'm not able to concentrate. I'm fear of failure because all through my school days and thus far, I stood very well in my academics. And I'm not able to bear the pain of my brother passed away suddenly. And I cannot do anything. I don't want to do, continue my study. Then I asked her, tell me anyone in the world who did not lose anything. She said that don't counsel me in this regard, but I cannot accept my brother's death and I cannot study. And with sincere prayer and a burden in my heart, I spoke to her and I called her parents there itself and I spoke to them. Then I told, I'll continue to pray, don't spoil your future because none of us are escaping from the death. We are bound to lose people in our life. No one can escape from that thing. But think about your future. Then after a few weeks, I came to know from the organizer that this girl came back and she's continuing her study. Students of Karunya, after this assembly, when you are going to your class, you need to have your fresh mind to gather the learning in your classrooms. 6 hours or 7 hours of the day that you and I need to keep our mind free to learn the lessons that which has been taught in the classroom, for which that you have paid to sit in your classroom. If your mind is occupied with the losses, with the pain, with the agony, with the emotional hurt, with the disappointment, and you cannot excel in the process of learning. All of us, we hear excellently in the class, but learning process may not happen to that level because your mind might be occupied with many things. Like this girl experienced great agony and she said that I'm not able to sit in the class. I cannot learn anything. Pain, disappointment, losses, discouragement is for you and is for me. No one can escape from that thing. But you and I need to know how to flush out our mind from such agony, such pain, such losses. How we can have a quick relief from such a thing and get into the process of progressing in our life. The verse that which I read to you in the book of Genesis chapter 41, verse 51, Joseph He received his first son. He named him as Manasseh. You know, in the Bible, every name is named with a great meaning. Prophetically, it will be given, or telling about the character of the person, or something, a great meaning will be attached to the name given to in the Jewish family. Even you might have received the name from your parents saying that, you know, for this reason we have named you. Now, Joseph, he placed the name or given the name Manasseh to his son, the meaning that God made me to forget all my toil. God made me to forget all my pain. Many of you know what was the problem in Joseph's life. As a teenager boy, at the age of 17, as he was living happily, luxuriously in the presence of his father, suddenly something happened. Brothers started hating him. They went to the extent of killing this boy. And they threw him in the pit. Later he was sold as a slave. And all through his life he was so sincere, filled with integrity. And he was filled with fear of God. All through days he lived with such kind of an attitude. But you know that he was falsely accused. And he was thrown in the prison. At the age of 17, the suffering started. At the age of 30, he became a governor of the nation of Egypt. 13 long years, this guy went through a tremendous pain, losses, disappointment, hurts, one after another. And he carefully names his son, saying that, appreciating the creative power of God, appreciating God, you know, with all his wisdom, how he created the brain of the man, you know, remembering that, he named his son as Manasseh. That means, I am no more dwelling in my past. The loss is for sure for me, the disappointment can come, the pain can come, but I am not going to cling to all those things, because my God has created in my brain some part which through which I can forget this misery. That's the simple reason, appreciating God's creation and the creativity power. And with that thought, he named his son Manasseh. God made me to forget. You know, always, especially the teachers and parents, we appreciate students with good memory power. A person with good memory power is always appreciated, applauded. You know, when my children bring the report card, you know, when I see some less mark in any subject, first thing I'll ask, what is your friend, the one who stands first, how much mark? How come you reduced in this one? Where is your brain? We give so much importance to the, you know, remembering part of the brain, and many times we fail to appreciate that we have in the brain some part which can make us to forget. It is always good, better. Otherwise, remember how you and I can live in this world happily by all those hurts, all those losses and the disappointments stored, and it is getting enriched in your mind, not able to forget. How that you and I can have a good brain to excel in our academics and research or whatever the area that you want to excel. It is impossible. Joseph understood the great secret, you know, from the working of the hands of the Lord in framing the brain. Many a time, my mother used to tell me, eat vendaka. You know, if you eat this one, you will have good memory power in making, you know, doing maths. Many a time we give vallare keerai tablet to our children because we think that our children are mark producing machines and they have to excel in their studies. We always concentrate of making our brain something supernatural, something should remember anything and everything, an encyclopedia or a dictionary, something is there and my children should do well. But we fail to appreciate, what if that losses, what if that agony, what if that hurt, if it is not erased out from your memory, if it is not able to be flushed out from your memory, how you will be in the process of learning, how you will be excellent in the process of building good relationship, how you will be able to progress in your life. It is good to have good memory power, and it is also good to have memory loss in terms of our agony in terms of our disappointment, in terms of losses, so that every day morning when you sit at the feet of the Lord, tell Him to flush out your mind. And as He flushes out your mind with His presence and the Word of God, you will come as a fresh vessel next day morning and the first hour of the class till evening. You will be able to learn. And learning is the important process which should happen in the classrooms, not just hearing alone, so that you will excel in your memory power. You will excel in learning. You will excel in your academic knowledge. And that will pave a way for you to succeed. Father, we thank You for this time that You've given to us, O Father God. Father, many times we give importance to the good memory. It is important, but at the same time, O Father God, we fail to appreciate the memory loss areas, the brain nerves which works to erase the losses, erase the disappointment, erase the hurts, O Father God, and erase the agony in our life. It has been created by You. Father God, we love You and thank You for being a great God filled with all wisdom in making us perfect and complete, O Father God. We love You and thank You as Joseph remembered and appreciated Your creativity power. And Lord Father God, as He named His son as Manasseh, that God made me to forget all my toils, all my pain. As He was refreshed in Your presence, I pray for myself and all our dear students. I do not know how many of them are going through disappointment, losses, agony, or broken relationship. I do not know, but You know, Father God. I place each and every one of us at Your precious feet carefully. Give me and all of us the grace, O Father, to quickly forget our losses, to recover from our agony, to come back very fast, O Father, from our disappointed state, to forget about all those hurts what we received from one another. Help me and everyone to wash it out at Your feet and come as with a fresh mind, O Father. Help me and everyone to start our day with a fresh mind, purging everything in Your presence, flushing out in Your presence, O Father God, so that, O Father, our learning process inside the classrooms of our dear students will be better and will be improving. Bless them, O Father God, in such a way that today's learning in all related activities towards learning, O Father, will be a beneficial one for our student community. Bless them. I also pray for their parents, siblings and grandparents who are far away. Put a hedge around them that they're going out and coming and be blessed and protected, O Father God. We love You and thank You, Lord. Help us to carry out our work, administrative work, teaching, learning, research, and whatever the assignment today we have. Help us to carry it out with diligence. In Jesus' precious name, we thank and pray. Amen.